So there are a lot of ways for single women to build their family. Obviously, in order to achieve a pregnancy, you need eggs, you need sperm, and you need a place to carry that embryo, to carry ultimately the baby. And so if you are a single woman, assuming everything else is okay, and you're sort of, you know, in your mid to late 30s, there are a lot of different ways to go ahead and build a family. The first is to decide on where the sperm is going to come from. Are you going to use sperm from somebody that you know, a directed donor, or are you going to use sperm from a sperm bank? And so that's the first thing to think about. Once you've chosen sperm, then the next step, obviously, is to work towards achieving a pregnancy. Simply because you don't have sperm doesn't automatically mean that you're fertile. And sperm, particularly if you're getting it from a sperm bank, is not cheap. And so oftentimes we do an evaluation to make sure that everything else is okay, that the uterus is okay, that the tubes are open, and we evaluate the egg reserve. What is the likelihood that you'll be able to achieve a pregnancy? And then we go ahead and talk about different ways for you to be able to build your family. And so, is it best to go ahead and do donor insemination, and where we take the sperm, we process it, or it already comes from the sperm bank process, and we just put it into your uterus when you're ovulating, when the egg is ready? Or do we use additional technology and do in vitro fertilization, where we take your eggs out, put the eggs and the sperm together in order to make an embryo, and then put an embryo back into your uterus? How we decide which approach depends on a number of factors. It depends on your age. It depends on how many children you want to have. So if you, for example, are 37 and you want to have 5 children, you're going to be pretty far along in age by the time you're ready to have that 5th child. So it would be great to be able to make embryos at 37 to be able to use later. It depends on whether the rest of the testing comes back okay. So there are a number of different factors that we consider and decide together in terms of how to best approach your family building. So there are a lot of things that go into selecting a donor. It's a pretty big decision that you're making. And so one of the first things is to decide whether it's going to be somebody that you know or not. And if it is somebody that you know, I would strongly recommend that you have a contract drawn up, that roles, rights, responsibilities are very clearly defined in advance. Oftentimes it also helps to work with a mental health professional to just explore again what the relationship is going to be like. You may select using somebody that you know because of who they are, because you want them to be in your life, you want them to be hopefully in your child's life. If you're selecting sperm from a sperm bank, there are a number of things to take into consideration as well. Physical characteristics, tall, less tall. Educational background, college educated, not college educated, graduate school. Hobbies and interests, some people will go with ethnic background. Religion, people will often choose on. And then there are medical things to think about as well in terms of selecting a donor. And those are the things that we would work together on to help you choose what's going to be the right donor for you, particularly as it relates to the medical decisions that need to be made in donor selection. Receiving fertility care involves a lot of different things. Have to check whether your insurance is going to cover your treatment or not cover your treatment. And we have financial coordinators that work with you to help determine those kinds of things. If you're using donor sperm, again, particularly with somebody that you know, we recommend that you use an attorney, and we have a number of attorneys that we work with who have very specific expertise in this area. And it's really important that you work with somebody who understands some of the implications, all of the implications that are associated with using donor sperm. We do have a group of mental health professionals that we work with whose expertise is in third-party reproduction. So third-party reproduction is the term that's used for using donor sperm or donor eggs or a gestational surrogate, somebody to carry a pregnancy for you. And so we have a series of professionals that are able to help provide you with all of the information you need to help move the process along, in addition, obviously, to the clinical care that you're going to receive from your nurse and obviously from your doctor. We just talked about a number of different things that come up when you're looking to build your family as a single mother by choice. As you can see, there are lots of options that are available to you. And we at RMA are here to help you along your journey.